प्रमोद सर सनसनवाल सर को भी ज्वाइन करना पड़ेगा ना। हेलो
वो जोशी मैडम, कुछ प्रॉब्लम हो गई थी उनके कनेक्शन में। आप ठीक है ना जोशी
जी मैडम,
मैडम?
आप जी सर, आप ठीक है सर?
यस सर,
आप ठीक है? चलो ओके। आपके
ओके सर।
बच्चे चले गए हैं? 5 ही बच्चे हैं बस।
नहीं नहीं ज्वाइन कर रहे हैं सर, 36 39 हो गए हैं, आ रहे हैं।
तो मैं फिर इंतजार करूं 2-4 मिनट
हाँ सर, 3 4 मिनट इंतजार करते, वी विल देन कंटिन्यू।
ताकि वो
मैंने
बेचारे
मैसेज डाला है, प्लीज ज्वाइन अगेन।
लॉग इन हो जाए तो अच्छी बात।
जी,
आप जोशी मैडम बता देना, जब स्टार्ट करना हो मैं कर दूंगा।
जी सर। सर आप स्क्रीन शेयर करना पड़ेगा वापस शायद।
मेरे को क्यों?
हाँ जी, आपकी स्क्रीन नहीं दिखाई दे रही है,
अरे स्क्रीन अभी स्टार्ट ही
शेयर
नहीं
स्क्रीन। हाँ
मैंने
वही बोल रही हूँ मैं कि आपको वापस स्क्रीन शेयर करनी पड़ेगी।
आई एम जस्ट वेटिंग के लेट पीपल ज्वाइन। आप
ओके
ज्वाइन हो गए, मैं स्टार्ट
ओके
कर।
ओके हाँ जी सर, 45 स्टूडेंट्स आ गए हैं, आप स्टार्ट कर दीजिए सर।
ये देखो, ये आपको स्क्रीन दिखाई दे रही है अब? नहीं,
हाँ अब दे रही है।
तो मैं उस वक्त स्क्रीन शेयर नहीं की थी तो कैसे दिखाई?
वही कह रही थी मैं।
कोई बात नहीं, कोई बात
ये
सो डियर फ्रेंड, दिस वाज द टेबल विच आई थिंक यू हैव सीन, एंड आई वाज जस्ट नोटिंग डाउन द वैल्यूज दैट आई हैड मेल एंड फीमेल्स, द मीन स्कोर्स ऑफ क्रिएटिविटी ऑफ मेल स्टूडेंट इज 122.466, सो इट कैन बी 0.47, एंड द स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन इज 76.979, देन इट कैन बी 76.98। ओके, फीमेल इज 129.263, सो इट इज 26, एंड स्टैंडर्ड डेविएशन 72.590, सो 59, एंड द टी वैल्यू हियर इज 0.558, सो इट इज 0.56, एंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर टी वैल्यू यू सी योर एरर इज 57.8%। एंड योर एरर मस्ट बी 5% और लेस देन 5%, सो इट इज मोर देन दैट, सो योर दिस वैल्यू इज नॉट सिग्निफिकेंट। नाउ हियर इट इज ए माइनस साइन, एंड टी कैनॉट बी माइनस, बिकॉज वाई माइनस साइन? बिकॉज हियर इट इज 122.47 माइनस 129, इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ दैट। And if I do your analysis again like this, that earlier I first wrote the male, and now if I say female first and then male, and then see the answer is exactly the same. Now it is not minus. So it is 0.558, it is 0.558. So in your output, if you have minus, do not bother, but when you are reporting, you should not report minus, you should report plus. Because the difference is always a scalar quantity, it is not a vector quantity. So that is what important. So I have noted down these values, and then let me now go to the word file, and then let us say, how do I do it? So I have written, so the first objective was this, the data were analyzed with the help of t-test, and the results are given in 4.1, are given in table 4.1, because this is the fourth chapter. And the first table in the chapter number 4, and that is why it is 4.1. When you are giving first table in chapter number 3, then it should be written as table 3.1. And now here I have to make a table. Table 4.1. I am inserting the table, auto fit. Now here I say gender, and then I say mean, then I say standard deviation, then I say n, and then I say t value. I have already noted down the values. Here it is male, then female. The male is the mean score of creativity is 122.47, and female is 129.26. Standard deviation is 76.98, and the female is 72.59, and males are 75 and females are 76, and t value is 0.56, and it is not significant. So here the table heading is gender wise, mean, SD, N, and T values. These values I have written as plural because mean value, SD value, and N value, and T value. So that is why I have written the values like that. Right? T values of creativity of students, and do not put a full stop, because the table heading, no heading has a full stop, so please don't put the full stop. Okay, now then I have to write, I'll say from from table 4.1. 8 can be seen that the t value is 0.56, which is not significant. So it reflects that when t is not significant, the meaning is that these two means do not differ significantly. It reflects that there is no significant difference in mean scores of creativity of male and female students. And the hypothesis which you must have written is like this. So the third sentence, thus the null hypothesis that, because you have written the hypothesis in chapter number 1, and this is your chapter number 4, so you must rewrite that. Your objective was written in chapter number 1, and here I have again written for the benefit of the reader. If you say that the first objective was, and if you do not write, then the reader has to go to chapter number 1 and then see what was your objective. So for the benefit of the reader, it is advisable to repeat some of the things like objective and hypothesis. Thus the null hypothesis that there is no significant difference in mean mean scores of creativity of male and female students. Okay, is not rejected. When you write is not rejected, that means your hypothesis has been tested. And now you say it may therefore be said that both male and female students were found to be equally creative. Are found to be equally creative. So this becomes your finding. And this is how this particular chapter should be written. And if you have another objective, then go ahead. And how you analyze the data, this is how you have to do it. And then side by side, when you are writing this, then you should also develop this was 4 point. Suppose I'm just writing like that. I'm saying findings. And I say the following were the findings of this study. And then here I say first. So this is my first finding. And here I say both male and female students were found to be equally creative. Then like this, I will write my second finding. And then similarly, I will write my third finding. So this is how you should do. And if you have written your this chapter systematically, then writing the finding is not at all difficult one. And then the next chapter will be your next chapter will be fifth one, and this will be titled as discussion. My dear friend, I will advise even the PG students also, it is better not to club the discussion with results and interpretation. Because many people, they do not write a separate chapter on discussion. Do not say discussions, it is discussion. It's not S, it's not plural, it is singular. And this chapter is your contribution. Because here you have to think and then you have to justify why you got such type of results. So the discussion has to be done by you. So this is a very, very important one. And so this will be 5.1.0 introduction. Then you say the results and their interpretation have been given objective wise in the previous chapter. In the same chapter, the findings, have also been given. Okay. The present chapter, each finding has been discussed, and presented in captions. And now here, the 5.2.0. Now here, the same caption. Please see what you wrote here. This. The same caption you will write. Up to even the objective you will write. So this is what you will write. Okay. And then here you write your finding. This was your finding. The first objective was the finding was that both male and female students were found to be equally creative. So you can immediately see that this particular finding is related to this particular objective. Now, here, you have to say that this finding is supported by. Now, here, you have to use the sum up which you have done in your review of related literature. So the sum up of the review of related literature you used in order to write your rationale, and now you will use it here in the discussion. Then you say this finding is supported by whatever are the names, say Joshi, and it may be Sharma. Okay. And whatever is the year. And if it is Mathur, whatever was the year. Okay, and if there is any other one, say Sharma, and it is okay. So you have done this, but there might be some findings which might have been different. Then you can say, but here you have to write those findings which contradicted this finding. But it was contradicted, it was contradicted by that this finding is supported by Joshi and this, but contradicted. If you don't want to write that, but contradicted by. Now, whatever that you write, if it is Pargaonkar 1998, then whatever are the other one. These you have got it from review of related literature. So I hope you have understood it. And that is why your review of related literature should be done very carefully and sincerely. Because if your related literature is done sincerely, then you will have lot of researches to cite. Now, after you have given those researches which are supporting your finding and those researches which are not supporting your finding, you have written that. Now you have to write that why such a thing has happened. That why both boys and girls were found to be equally creative. So you have to think that what might be the reason. So you can think something like this, that in the school, the same content is taught to the boy as well as girl. The same method of teaching is used for boys and the girls in the same school. Okay, the class is of the same duration. The other activities, whatever are being done, they are done equally for male as well as female. Okay, and then you can say at home, the parents are providing equal opportunity and parents are giving the same facility to both their son and the daughter, and so on and so forth. So therefore, looking to this particular scenario, it is quite possible that both male and female were found to be equally creative. You know, so this particular aspect you have to develop. And you cannot develop this if you have not really studied your related literature carefully. And if you do not understand the variable that you are studying, and you must understand the population from which you have taken that sample. And if you do not understand all these things, then it will be very difficult for you to write this particular chapter. So once you have written 5.2.0, then 5.3.0, 5.4.0, all this, whatever it is. So this is what you have to do. And this completes your results. And this completes your discussion. And before that was your results and interpretation. At your master's level also, I will suggest, because at master level, you are giving training to your students, that if they want to do their research further, then naturally they must know everything very systematically. Yes, Shweta, what do you want to ask is not rejected. What do you want to ask here? What is the question? Do you want to ask a question or you want to just?
Nothing, sir. Sir, she has said nothing.
Okay. All right. Okay. That's fine. Nice.
Okay.
Maruji, namaskar aapko.
Thank you very much, sir.
Maruji ke darshan ho gaye.
नहीं सर,
मैं तो आज ही देखा है आपको, आपके दर्शन तो आज ही हुए. ओके, सो दिस इज हाउ यू राइट योर दिस पर्टिकुलर चैप्टर. माय डियर friend, if you are not very good in expression, the expression power is very important. There are students, they have such a nice expression that they really write this particular chapter very well. So I was telling you that even if you are the master's MPhil student or MPed student or MA student, whatever it is, and if you are really carrying out a small project or dissertation, you should write this chapter. Because if you will write this chapter, you will get a training as how this chapter is to be written. And later on, if you decide to do your PhD or decide to pursue your research or decide to take up a job where you have to do research, then this will help you. Now, with this, this particular chapter is over. And then the next chapter is your, the sixth chapter. I think this was the fifth chapter. Yes, this was the fifth chapter. So this will be your sixth chapter. And this sixth chapter will be summary, comma, findings, and I normally prefer to write implication. Because the people must understand from your research that how you think that the finding of your research can be implemented. And who are the people who can get the maximum benefit from your finding. So that is why writing implications is very, very, very important. And I have not seen many PhD theses where people write implication, they write suggestion. I personally do not feel that suggestion for further research really is very important. If you want to give suggestion, well, you can give suggestion. Whether somebody accepts your suggestion or they can have a better problem to work on, so that you can decide. But my suggestion is you should think of the implication of your research. And if that be so, then your 6.1.0 will be introduction. And this particular chapter, you have not to write much from your side except the implication. Everything you have to take it from the previous chapters. So you say the discussion of findings of this study have been or has been given in the previous chapter. The present chapter in the present chapter. The in the present chapter, the summary. In the present chapter, the summary of this study has been given under captions like one. You have to write the rationale. Okay. Next, you have to write the statement of problem. Then you have to write the. Then you have to write the hypothesis. Then you have to write the sample. Then you have to give the tool or tools, whatever it is. Then if it is an experimental design, then experimental design. Experimental design. And then you have to give the procedure. Data collection and then data analysis then findings. Okay. In this chapter, summary of this has been given. And this and findings along with this, the implications of this study has also been given. Okay. Have also been given. Okay. Then it is 6.2.0. So here you have to write the rationale. Now you have already written rationale in chapter number one. So if you can condense that particular rationale and write it here, and if you cannot condense, then sometime people copy and paste here. 6.3.0. Statement of problem. You have written in chapter number one, just copy and paste, nothing. Then 6.4.0, objectives. You have written in chapter number one, just copy and paste. Because you cannot shorten all these, then hypothesis. You have written in chapter number one, copy and paste. So the rationale, what you have presented in chapter one, in the summary, you may cut short and write only main things. Statement no need of changing objectives, no need of changing hypothesis, no need of changing. Write exactly you have written in chapter number one. 6.6.0 will be your sample. Now you have given the sample in detail in your third chapter. Here you need not to give so much detail, because there you have make a table and distribution of the sample with respect to different parameters you have given. You need not to give that here. Here you can talk about the population. You can talk about the sampling technique. You can talk about the sample size. And you can give the main characteristics. Main characteristics of the members of the sample. So you just have to write one paragraph, nothing else, not more than that. If anyone is interested, can go to your chapter number 3 and can get the additional information, whatever he wants. Then the tool or tools. You have described the tools in detail there. You can say that this variable was assessed with the help of this tool. You can give the name of the tool, name of the variable, name of the tool, and name of the developer. And you can talk about the reliability and the validity, that's all. So maybe 4 sentences or 5 sentences. Then 6.8.0, if it is the experimental design, you have given the, in chapter 3, you have this written experimental design in detail. Here you have to write name of the experimental design. Then name of treatment. Then duration of treatment. Okay. And the methods used for controlling intervening variables. So just one paragraph, then 6.9.0. And if you have not done an experimental study, then please do not write this. And then next is procedure. Procedure of data collection. You have already given this information in chapter number 3. Here, you can shorten that information, or if you are unable to shorten, then you can copy and paste, no problem at all. But if you can shorten it, it is much better. Then 6.10.0 is data analysis. Hindi, chapter number 3 you have already given, you copy and paste here. Finish. Findings in the results and interpretation, towards the end you have given the findings, so you can copy from there and you can paste it here. Then 6.12.0 is implications. I do not know whether you people are in habit or you have an experience of writing the implications. Because if you write the implication, it will help the people to take benefit of your finding. Because you have done that research, so you know how the people should bring change in their own way of working so that it is according to your the study. So here you should write that the findings of the present study, the findings of the present are you may be used by, say, I'm just writing by principle. Because if you have done some study related to the school, and if you see that the principal can bring certain changes on the basis of your, then it has an implication for the changes. Okay? And if it is for teachers, then what teachers can do, how teachers use your finding. If it is students, then how students should use it. If it is parents, then how parents should use it, etc., etc. If you say the administrator, okay, or if you say the education minister, so you have to think that who are the beneficiaries of your finding. And then after that, then say 6.12.1, say principle. Now here you have to say that this finding can be used by the principal. And how exactly you think the principal can use that finding. That means if I just give you that the male and female students were found to have creativity to the same extent, then I will say that whatever activities the school organizes, it should be both the same activities, both for male as well as female students. Okay, so the participation of both male and female students should be there. When the examples are given, or when some training program is organized, then because all those aspects which are under the domain of the principal, you have to write. And when you come to the teacher, then when the teacher is teaching in the class, then the teacher should give examples where he should highlight both the creativity of boys as well as girls, male as well as females. You can take a lot of example from daily life. The teacher can say that see both male and female are equally creative, because recently the four lady pilots, they had piloted the plane from US to India, and it is 16,000 kilometers away, and in one go non-stop they had a flight, and it was on a very different route they have taken. Not many people have taken that route, so they are very creative, you know, things like that. So what you can do is, this is how, and I'll tell you, if you write implication, your own thinking will develop. If you write your discussion, your thinking will develop. And you can get a lot of ideas. And once you have completed this, then after that, some people write the appendix. In that they, some give tool or something like this, no need of giving the data. But those who are not writing that, then after that, it is a bibliography. You have to have a separate page, and here, when you are giving, then you have to give it in the alphabetical order, and alphabetical not in the year, alphabetical order, and alphabetical order from the last name. And I have given you how exactly you have to write. If it is a paper written by one person, how will you write that? And if it is a paper written by two people or three people, how you write? If it is a paper written by more than three people, how you write? If it is thesis, how you write? Do not use the dissertation. I repeat, the MPhil dissertation or the master's dissertation should not be used, and they should not be the part and parcel of the bibliography. Why? Because the purpose of conducting the research at the master's level and MPhil level is to give training. So therefore, the quality of the research at master's and MPhil level might not be of some standard, because the purpose is not really to conduct, but the purpose is to give the training in how to conduct the research. But you have to refer to the PhD thesis. Why? Because you have already been trained and now you are conducting. You know, it is something like this, that when you want to learn the driving, then you first have a license. It is just a learning one. But once you have completed and you have gone through the test, then you have your independent license of driving. First is the learning license, and then it is a driving license. Okay, so it is something like this. Your MPhil or master's is a learning license, but PhD is your driving license type of thing. So do not quote that. And if you have to write here, those books which you might have read, but you did not refer, you did not, you know, quoted in your earlier chapters, but you might have been benefited from the idea, and that you can write here. And if it is a book, you know how it is to be written. Another is the website, you know how it is to be written. So this bibliography should be arranged alphabetically, not in the according to the year. No, it's alphabetic A, B, C, D. So with this dear friend, I have come to the presentation of this particular one. If you have any question, please go ahead and ask me the question. If any question from any participant, and later on Maru saab puchhenge, abhi nahi puchhenge, pehle students puchhenge.
Yes, sir.
Yes, please. Any student like to ask any question?
सर यहाँ पर हम लोग implications की जगह पे recommendations लिखा करते थे ना सर
नहीं रिकमेंडेशन जो होती है दैट इज फॉर फर्दर रिसर्च
ओके
एंड एक्चुअली सम टाइम रिसर्चर मे नॉट बी सो कॉम्पिटेंट दैट ही कैन सजेस्ट और ही कैन रिकमेंड दैट दिस टाइप ऑफ रिसर्च इज टू बी डन सो इट इज बेटर टू अवॉइड सर्टन थिंग्स लाइक दिस बट If you think there is a tradition and you want to continue with the old tradition, which is not good, you can continue. The choice is yours. But it's better that you should change. And then another is, it is PP, small. Then another is that when you are writing your references, I do not know whether you are following the latest one, 8th version or not, so that you can see which one you are following. So that you can follow. There is no problem at all.
Okay.
Any other question you want to ask? Okay. In bibliography, alphabetic order, not of the title, author. Author alphabetic order, not title.
सर वो बीच में हम डिस्कनेक्ट हो गए ना तब एक किसी ने क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन में क्वेश्चन डाला हुआ था कि अगर एब्स्ट्रैक्ट जब हम लिखते हैं तो उसमें आर वैल्यू एफ वैल्यू टी वैल्यू अगर ना हो तो लिखना चाहिए क्या
नो लेट मी टेल यू व्हेन यू आर राइटिंग द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट एंड व्हेन यू आर राइटिंग एक्चुअली द आई थिंक द क्वेश्चन व्हाट दे आर आस्किंग इज रिव्यू चैप्टर
Yes, with respect to review.
In the review chapter, you just have to write the finding. You have not to write the F value. You have not to write the T value. You have not to say whether it is significant or not. Okay, you only have to write the finding. And that is what I said. Objective, hypothesis, sample, the tool, and the statistical analysis and finding, that's all. So no need of saying it is significant or not, just finding, that's all, nothing else. Any other question? In bibliography, alphabetical order of the author. Author means the last name, not the first name. Okay, any other question?
No more questions, sir.
No more. Maruji, is
आपसे
मुलाकात नहीं हो रही है.
Yes. Sir, ये जो platform है ना फिलहाल वो थोड़ा restricted form में है तो आई एम देयर एवरी डे, इवन मैंने आपको मींस चैट में भी डाला हुआ है हर दिन.
मैंने पढ़ा था.
यस सर.
मैंने आपको नमस्कार भी किया था अगर आपने सुना हो तो.
यस सर. नमस्कार.
सर, हम लोग मिलते नहीं है पर वी ऑलवेज रिमेम्बर यू. हमारा कभी भी रिसर्च होता है ना सनसनवाल सर, तो आप हमेशा हमारे बीच में रहते ही हैं डिस्कशंस में.
आप लोगों को बहुत याद करता हूँ जब किसी से बात करता हूँ रिसर्च की.
यस सर, आप हमारे दिल में है सर. आपको देखकर इतनी खुशी होती है ना स्क्रीन पर. ये मैं है ना आपका 7वां या 8वां में बैठ रहा हूँ. इवन लास्ट जो मानसा कॉलेज का भी था ना, इसके पहले वाला, वो भी पूरे के पूरे 6 दिन मैंने अटेंड किए. और मेरे साथ जो मेरे PhD स्कॉलर्स जो थे वो चारों ने भी अटेंड किया था सर. खाली इतना है कि सर आप मीन्स हम आपको देख पा रहे, आप हमें नहीं देख पा रहे. दैट्स इट.
आई नो.
यस.
यस. और अगले और देव भगवान से प्रार्थना करते हैं कि अगले साल हमको आप स्वयं कॉलेज में दिखाई दें.
एक्स्ट्रा थोड़ा भगवान को जरा चढ़ाऊंगा. आप भी चढ़ाना, शायद भगवान मान जाए.
यस सर. मारू सर,
थैंक यू. सर मुझे एक जरा पूछना था कि नॉर्मली हम लोग जो references और ये सारा जो है वो हम लोग वर्ड के अंदर जो ऑप्शन आता है उसके थ्रू हम लोग सारी चीजें इनपुट करते हैं. जैसे अगर बुक हो, बुक का सेक्शन हो, जर्नल हो, वेबसाइट हो वगैरह, और फिर जब कभी भी हमको चाहिए तो वो जो लास्ट पेज रहता है उस पर्टिकुलर फाइल का, वहां पर हम रेफरेंसेस या बिब्लियोग्राफी जनरेट करते हैं और वो तो ऑटोमेटिकली अल्फाबेटिक ऑर्डर में ही आता है. तो क्या सर हम वो वैसे का वैसा ही ले या फिर उसमें भी कोई, क्योंकि एक मैंने वर्कशॉप अटेंड किया था तो उन्होंने बताया था कि जो वर्ड जो सॉफ्टवेयर है जिसके अंदर से अगर आप जनरेट करते APA स्टाइल के अंदर तो वो हूबहू APA स्टाइल में नहीं देता. तो बोला उसमें आपको चेंजेस करने पड़ते हैं. तो आप क्या सजेस्ट?
वो बात सही है. आप कैसे भी लो, एक फॉर्मेट इंपॉर्टेंट है. इफ यू गेट in the word like in that particular format, main aapse, I'll talk to you after 10 minutes. I'm in webinar. So therefore, wahan pe aapko, agar it is not in the same format, then naturally you should not.
Okay.
That is important. See, that is why many of the softwares have been developed. But many a times these softwares, whatever you get, say for example, SPSS. Now it gives you the output. You cannot just copy and paste. Not at all. That's what happens. So whatever.
लेकिन सर जो आपने अभी जो फॉर्मेट हमको ये 2 दिन में बताया ना, तो जब हम लोग वो जनरेट करते हैं तो वो सेम टू सेम ही आता है. वो कुछ मेरे ख्याल से फुल स्टॉप, कॉमा और जो बोलते हैं ना बोल्ड एंड इटालिक जो है ना, वो उसके कुछ चेंजेस आते हैं उसमें. वो बोलते हैं कि ये ऐसे नहीं होना चाहिए.
नहीं देखिए ना, अगर मान लीजिए वो आता है, एक बात मैं बताऊं आपको कि इफ यू आर राइटिंग समथिंग बोल्ड देन एवरी टाइम, if you are writing title bold, then everywhere title must be bold. If you are writing the name of the journal italics, then everywhere the name of the journal. Consistency is important. So that you have to maintain. Baki, you can go ahead. No problem at all.
यस सर. और सर हम लोग है ना references यूज करते हैं, बट आपने हर टाइम बिब्लियोग्राफी मेंशन किया है, तो क्या एग्जैक्टली मीन्स रेफरेंस लेना चाहिए या?
आई टोल्ड यू वी शुड नॉट राइट रेफरेंसेस. इफ सपोज यू आर रेफरेंसेस मीन्स व्हाट, व्हाटएवर यू हैव रेफर्ड इन सम चैप्टर, इफ यू आर जस्ट गिविंग दैट देन इट इज ए रेफरेंस. बट इफ यू आर गिविंग दोज बुक्स विच यू माइट हैव रेड and you might have benefited from the reading some ideas, but you have not quoted, then if such type of material is there, then that material, if you want to write, then it cannot become part of the references. Then it is part of the bibliography. So bibliography is broader than the references. So bibliography is equal to references plus non-referred material.
Yes, sir.
Whatever it is, whether it is your website or whatever it is you want to write, which you think that other researcher can benefit.
Okay. लेकिन सर हम लोग है ना जो हमारे थीसिस के अंदर जो जो हमने रेफरेंसेस लिए है ना हम उसी को ही दिखाते हैं एक्चुअली हम जो एडिशनल एक्स्ट्रा वरना कुछ टाइम ऐसे होता है कि जो एक्सटर्नल रेफरी आते हैं ना फिर वो पूछते हैं कि ये साइटेशन लिस्ट के अंदर है आप हमको यहाँ पर किसी एक चैप्टर के अंदर ये रिफ्लेक्ट होता हुआ हमें बताओ तो फिर वहां पर फिर ये
नहीं से अगर आपने वो रेफरेंस में लिखा है
तो वो कॉन्ट्रेडिक्ट होता है
पड़ेगा बट बिब्लियोग्राफी में लिखा है तो फिर आपको बताने की जरूरत नहीं है
ओके
अगर वो आदमी फिर भी एक्सपर्ट पूछता है इसको तो एक्सपर्ट को ये नहीं मालूम कि बिब्लियोग्राफी और रेफरेंस में क्या डिफरेंस है
यस
वो प्रॉब्लम इन दैट केस डू नॉट राइट बिब्लियोग्राफी राइट रेफरेंसेस
यस
करेक्ट सर एक क्वेश्चन है Can we write reviews manually instead of taking help of technology? Is it allowed or not?
No, you can write manually. Why not? Manually means what? You want to type. You can type.
Okay.
By type na.
Yes,
you can type. Format, if you want to see, then you have to find out whether that format fits into your case or not.
Correct. Yes, yes.
यस सर और सर एक जरा प्रमोद सर से रिक्वेस्ट था कि जो आपने जो अभी जितना भी वर्ड के अंदर जो टाइप किया हुआ है ना वो जरा अगर वो वर्ड की भी फाइल अगर हमको मिलती ना तो उससे कैसे और आइडिया क्लियर होता एक्चुअली मैं है ना पढ़ जब आपका प्रेजेंटेशन चलता है ना तो टाइम टू टाइम मैं ना स्क्रीनशॉट लेते रहता हूँ तो मेरे पास मोर देन 300 स्क्रीनशॉट हो गए हैं अभी उसको सिक्वेंस में लगाना बहुत दिक्कत होती है
Actually, yes, this is spoon feeding, or we are giving all recordings, and
really, recording is there.
Yes, yes, yes. If they can feel need, then they avail it. वो reverse करके देख सकते हैं. लेकिन अगर हम ये चाहें PPT भी मिले या words भी मिले तो उसमें बच्चे आजकल कर क्या रहे हैं सर? कि बहुत से टीचर्स उसको सर के मतलब कंटेंट वो सर का है लेकिन उसको वो अपने लेवल पे यूज कर लेते हैं
नहीं सर एक्चुअली सर को है ना हम लोग नियरली मैं सर को 9 years से जानता हूँ और सर के क्लासेस में 9 years से बैठ रहा हूँ तो सर ने अब तक में जितना भी सिखाया है ना वो सारा का सारा हमारे पास रिटर्न फॉर्म में है और कुछ कुछ तो हमने सॉफ्ट कॉपी में भी हमने कन्वर्ट किया था जो इवन सर को हम लोगों ने अप्रूवल के लिए भी दिया था कि ताकि ये सेम लाइन पर हम लोग है ना हमारे कॉलेज के अंदर भी कंटिन्यू कर पाए क्योंकि जो राइट डायरेक्शन में होना चाहिए इट शुड नॉट बी वेग तो इसीलिए क्योंकि ये जो पॉइंटर्स है ना वो हम लोगों को हेल्प करेगी
मैं आपकी बात से बिल्कुल सहमत हूँ लेकिन वो सारा कंटेंट वीडियो रिकॉर्डिंग्स में ऑलरेडी है
ओके
अगर कोई भी थोड़ा सा भी उसमें मेहनत करना चाहेगा तो वो कर सकता है और बना सकता है
ओके सर नो प्रॉब्लम ओके
और आप करना आप रिकॉर्डिंग देख लेना आपको ना मिले आप मेरे को मेल भेज देना मैं आपको भेज दूंगा डोंट वरी
ओके सर
ओके ओके
थैंक यू वेरी मच सर
ओके सर आपका जो नॉलेज आपने शेयर किया इसके लिए सर मन दिल से धन्यवाद आपके थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर योर वैल्यूएबल प्रेजेंस एंड गाइडेंस थैंक यू सर
नमस्कार
एंड सर
नाइस टाइम और प्रे